or she lies sleeping? Will the flowers shed their petals there? Will the dew drop strong upon the roses where my darling sleeps beneath the sand? Her eyes were like the starlit sky, her lips were like a bunch of roses, her hair was dark, it was curly. I'll love her till the day I die. Will the roses bloom where she lies sleeping? Will the flowers shed their petals there? Will the dew drops fall upon the roses where my darling sleeps beneath the sand? Underneath the beautiful sky, I'll miss her since she has left me. I'll miss her till the day I die. Will the roses bloom where she lies sleeping? Will the flowers shed their petals there? Will the dewdrops fall upon the roses where my darling sleeps beneath the sand? Where my darling sleeps beneath the sand.
Thank you so much. Well, this is our first time playing in Asheville, so thank you guys for making it such a warm welcome. To be honest, this is kind of like our first show ever in a lot of ways. I don't know if you know anything about us individually or together, but we got married a couple years ago, and we have only been living in the same country for a few months now, because Tabitha is from Northern Ireland. I grew up in South Carolina, and we just met over, you know, love of this music. So I'm really excited to be playing some music together, and we'll play some more, you know, kind of traditional sounding and original sounding bluegrass music. This one's an original. It's one that we wrote and recorded recently, and we named it after our little puppy, Finn, that we got a few months ago. He's kind of a COVID puppy, and he's kind of made our lives a lot brighter, so this one's named after him. It's called Finn's Rescue. Thank you.
thank you guys so much. We're going to play a couple of songs for you now from the repertoire of Flat and Scruggs. I'm sure you're all familiar with Flat and Scruggs. If you're not, yeah, I hope so, because if I said that back in Northern Ireland, I would get a resounding silence in the room. So I'm just so thankful to play here in North Carolina, and people actually know who that is. It's awesome. Yeah. But this is a great song called Don't Get Above Your Reason, and yeah, it's a fun one to play with David. Well, I've got a gal that's sweet to me. She just ain't what she used to be. She's a little high-headed, that's plain to see. Don't get above your reason. Stay down earth with me. Don't you hide me. I ain't forgot what you used to be. When you didn't have nothing, that's plain to see. Don't get above your reason. Stay down to earth with me. Now you don't need to hold your head so high. Every time you pass me by, your country baby, that's plain to see. Don't get above your reason. Stay down to earth with me. My strings. Well, look here, gal, you better be yourself and put the other boys on the shelf. You're a country baby, that's plain to see. Don't get above your reason. Stay down to earth with me.
Thanks. We'll play another one from Flat and Scruggs. And I was just kind of thinking about this song on the way up today. We're kind of semi-local. We've been living in South Carolina for the past few months. We're actually getting ready to close on a house in Traveler's Rest, which we're really excited about, and excited about being closer to you guys, only about an hour away. But on the drive up, I was just thinking about this song. It's a beautiful one from Flat and Scruggs called Rough and Rocky. And like that, yeah, you guys know this one. Aw, it's a sweet song, isn't it? And the chorus is, don't this road look rough and rocky, don't that sea look wide and deep, don't my baby look the cutest when she's in my arms asleep. And, you know, we've had to spend a lot of time on opposite ends of the Atlantic Ocean in our relationship, and it's so great to get to be in the same spot, be in the same country, and get to share music with each other, so share music with you all, so thanks for being a part of this. We'll try this one out for you, Rough and Rocky.
This song's gonna be rough and rocky if you don't let me tune for just a second, please. I mean, it might already be rough and rocky, even if I am in tune, but.
You guys enjoying your food? Yeah. We had the pasta primavera. It's pretty good. Yeah, shout out to the kitchen staff and all the folks waiting here. It's an awesome place, isn't it?
Many miles apart. Don't this road look right? Can't you hear the night birds crying? Far across the deep blue sea. Ooh, others you are thinking. Won't you sometimes think of me? I'm sure most of you know this year has been a strange one, if any. And I guess this time last year, David was stranded, is like how he likes to put it, stranded in Northern Ireland, which, you know, isn't insulting at all, of course. But literally, you know, we couldn't go anywhere and everything was closed. Like, I mean, everything pretty much was closed down. And he couldn't drive, so I guess you were stranded, actually, the more I think about that. But anyway, so we were over there, and I kind of finished this song during that period of being together there. I think I started it when David was living in Boston, and we weren't married at that stage, and I finished it last year, and it has a theme in it, and it's basically about not wanting to be stuck right in the middle of a city when something happens. And so that was kind of the view that I took. And I'm a country girl from Northern Ireland, a very, very small country and very small countryside. So this kind of resonated with me, but it's called City.
I guess now you're stranded in the Carolinas, aren't you? Yeah.
Except I can almost drive.
Almost drive.
City caps and coffee cups. Everything's on the hour. Never time to take a shower. There's people in the parking lot. Anywhere to take a walk. To and fro, the come and go. Not the kind to say hello. Take the time to look around. There's no need to be afraid.
ridicule of being late, speeding up because they hate the ridicule of being late. Hey, Mr. Won't you just slow down and take the time to look around. There's no need to be afraid, see beyond the city gates, beyond the city.
Thanks so much. Well, I feel like you guys know pretty much everything about us. We do like to travel a lot, and I've only been, I don't even know if I've been to Mississippi before. I think I actually misspelled Mississippi on our set list here. I just spelled it Mississippi. Yeah, you can spell it.
We were homeschooled, so that's probably why. Mississippi. I didn't say it quite as fast as I once did a long time ago, but you're just gonna have to believe me that I can say it that fast.
This one's called Mississippi.
It's actually called Jump the Mississippi.
That's right.
Maybe that's why you spelled it wrong. You didn't get it right. Okay, sorry. Kidding. You ready?
All right, I'm ready.
1, 2, 3, 4.
Much too long. If you can't get your dime, if you came back home, honey, you hold your left, me hold you tight. Your tears keep falling and my eyes are blurred. If I had the wings of a pretty little bird, I would fly right to your arms tonight. I'd jump the Mississippi deep and wide if you was waiting on the other side. Honey, just a hug and hold you tight. I'd jump across and never get wet, right there by your side and said, yes, indeed, everything will be all right. Used to be, I'd sit out and meet you halfway. I'd run here and I'd never look back. I'd jump a mile in a minute flat to get to you before the end of the day. I'd jump the Mississippi deep and wide if you was waiting on the other side. Honey, just a hug and hold you tight. I'd jump across and never get wet, right there by your side and said, yes, indeed, everything will be alright. I'd jump the Mississippi deep and wide if you was waiting on the other side. Honey, just a hug and hold you tight. jump across and never get wet. Right there by your side, it said, yes, indeed, everything will be all right. Yes, indeed, everything will be all right.
So I think the last tour that I was a part of was the very start of last year in January, when I toured with my my brothers and David here in a band called Cup of Joe, and we toured around England and some of Northern Ireland, and I'm trying to remember what that has to do with this next song, but okay, I do know the connection, okay. So with that band, Cup of Joe, I have recorded a lot of Sam Henry songs. And if you're not familiar with Sam Henry, he was a really amazing song collector from Ulster, which is a province in Northern Ireland, and kind of like Alan Lomax kind of character. And he would go around and collect songs from people in the communities and different counties of Ulster. And this next song is one that he collected, and it's actually collected kind of not too far from where I live, or my folks live now, and it's just a really pretty song. And I found the lyrics in a big songbook of like 1,000 songs, and this one kind of stuck out to me, so I decided to get David to record it with me, and he graciously agreed. And we just released it on our EP that you can get online. We decided to release it as a digital EP because, well, you know, basically the fact that we've had no gigs, we can't really afford to print out anything. But you know, so we released it on there, and it's just a really fun one to record. So this is Leaves So Green.
Speaking of that EP, I don't know if you saw like these little pamphlets that we put on your tables, but if you'd like to listen to any of this music that we're playing tonight, you can grab our EP over on Bandcamp at that QR code on that leaflet there. But we'll play this one for you, Leaves So Green. Thank you.
cried at times, and these huntsmen I never loved to tread to the sheltered field of the lonely glen. My weary spirit fled, so bear me, my dearest, go far away by others' eyes and see where gleams of the sunshine early stray beneath the leaves so green. So bear me, my dearest, go far away by others' eyes and see where gleams of the sunshine early stray beneath the leaves so green.
Thank you so much. So we're going to try a new song of mine now that I just finished about yesterday, I think. And still might not be finished, honestly. But I shouldn't have told you that. Okay, actually, I need to go tune right back there. If you could just keep things rolling.
Oh, man. Hi. I would usually say banjo jokes now, but when you marry a banjo player, that's off the table. we'll be playing like some different songs from different projects. We do have like a couple of CDs in the back there. If you guys even still have a CD player, I must confess, I don't even know if I have one. But we've got some stuff back there, and you can check the stuff out online. But if you like what you hear and you'd like for us to come back, the best way to stay in touch is just find us on social media. I know it's like it's a terrible thing, social media, but it is nice for staying in touch. So find us on Facebook or Instagram, and we'll let you know when we're back in the area. Because this is a pretty awesome area, isn't it? How many of you folks are local here tonight? Ah. Any out-of-towners as well? Ooh, nice. Well, you out-of-towners have to bring us to your hometowns as well. So, you know, get us on the phone here. We'll play this one. This is a new one Tabitha mentioned. It's called Waves. I don't even know what this one's about. What
would you say this one's about?
It's up for discussion, so let us know what you think after the show.
Don't you know? I'm kidding.
Watch the waves as they hit the shore, and it's a mighty kind of current never seen before. Just like my tears when they take me by surprise, and all the hidden crevices they seem to hide. The storm that causes all the waves to rise is the same storm that gets me to the other side. Through it all, it brings me to my knees. Right in it all, I never reach the mighty deep. When we hear the thunder, we can only wonder how in all the misery the storm is saving me. Currents rising higher, it's a wicked kind of creature, but I can see much clearer now through the raging sea. I wish that if I had wings I could fly alone. But I am sheltered by another's wings, and there's safety and there's comfort in all they bring. When we hear the thunder, we can only wonder how in all the misery the storm's saving me. Well, the current's rising higher, it's a wicked kind of creature, but I can see much clearer now through the raging sea.
Thank you so much. Well, you were the first audience to really hear that one, so I appreciate that. So we're gonna do another one from the EP, and this is a song that I wrote, I guess, about 5 years ago? No, 5 years ago? I can't remember. I think it was about 5 years ago. The last year is gone in my mind, so I guess so. I'm not very good at maths. But yeah, I wrote this actually after coming back from IBMA, which I'm sure some of you might be familiar with. It's the bluegrass get together of the year, and it happens over in Raleigh, and that's where I kind of got, I guess, into bluegrass a lot more, just going there with my family. And it's actually where I met David, and I met a lot of friends, and I think I wrote this song on the way back on the plane, so it has a lot of good memories with it. But it's on our EP that you can grab online, and it's one called Knowing You. What is love apart from knowing you? Is it something we must feel or we must do? And is it just a golden ring or something else insane? What is love apart from knowing you? What is hope apart from knowing you? Is it something we can't take or we can lose? And you're a light strong and true, no shadows and no dew. The hope of life is found in you. When the soul sees its insecurity and looks to the one who made all we see, giving us new life and deserving of thee. There is nothing good without you. Can there be joy apart from you? And is it something we can't take or we can lose? When times are tough in life, can seem so cruel. There's no joy apart from you. When the sorrow sees its insecurity and looks to the one who made all we see, giving us new life and deserving of thee. There is nothing good without you.
can there be peace apart from you? Why would we trust ourselves to make it through? No peace beyond our wildest dreams. You came to give us peace by knowing you. And this world says insecurity and looks to the one who made all we see, giving us new life undeservingly. There is nothing good without you. When the soul sees insecurity and looks to the one who made all we see, giving us new life undeservingly. There is nothing good without you.
Thanks. We've been watching the Gilmore Girls recently. I'm kind of new to that. Have you guys seen it? I assume. Yeah.
Hold on. That's not good. So before that, we were watching The Middle. Has anyone else watched The Middle out there? Yeah. Okay. And we're trying to figure out, like, I don't know. There's a little theme song at the start of The Middle, and it has like a mandolin in it. And I think we shamelessly watched all 9 seasons, which took up a lot of our lives, but. You know, what else are you supposed to do with a puppy and he just sleeps on you? You can't get up, right? I mean, like, you gotta sit there and watch TV. So, I was just saying that before. We're trying to figure out who's the mandolin player on that. So if you know who the mandolin player is, come tell us. You probably don't, but I just wanted to redeem the Gilmore Girl situation there. I felt like that was not right, but okay.
Well, I just brought that up because this next song, for some reason, just reminds me of the Gilmore Girls. Not the way it sounds, but I just got Gilmore Girls on the mind, I guess. We got an hour drive back, and then we're on season 2, episode 10, and we'll see. But it's something charming about, like, kind of small town. Is it Connecticut? Is that right? Chilton, I think. How do I know all this?
Stars Hollow,
okay, yeah. Chilton's where the school is, right? Yeah, okay.
You're that kind of person. Right?
Yeah. But this is a nice song. And it's called Put All Your Troubles Away. And something about like a small town makes you want to put all your troubles away, I guess, because you have to live with your neighbors and all that.
Do it.
That's a stretch.
There was 9 seasons. I mean, like, it's not like they had a great time. Obviously, they had stuff to talk about.
I guess
you know?
So, yeah.
Drama and all that.
But anyway. They always put their troubles away at the end, right? That's...
I'm never forgiving you for this.
Okay. Take the song to heart here.
Yeah.
All right.
That's me. I could have swore this banjo just got off a boat from Ireland because it's so out of tune. Maybe it did.
How good that you look to me still. Yesterday we doubted each other. You turned as I walked down the hill. Give me her hand for the memories. Care not what the others may say. Give me her heart, let's be happy. Put all your troubles away. Thank you.
Any Fleetwood Mac fans out there? Ooh. You probably know this one then. Yeah, we first got here to the States, I guess back in August last year, and with live shows still on hold and you know, with nothing to do at home, we just did a bunch of live streams and decided to do them all as wacky, weird themes. So we did one a while back where we thought it'd be fun to play the music of Fleetwood Mac with the music of Bill Monroe. And yeah, kind of an interesting juxtaposition. Fleetwood Bill or Bill Mac. That's something else, isn't it? I forget. But anyways, we won't do the Bill Monroe part for you, but this is our Fleetwood Mac cover here.
Yeah, I made sure that we dressed up for each live stream, and I dressed up as Stevie Nicks, and David pulled off a really funny Bill Monroe, honestly. He had a little hat, and it was tiny. And you should go watch it again, not for the content, but just for the imagery. You know, just meet it, just while you're watching.
Watch the live stream. Definitely go watch the live stream, and I feel like now I,
forgot how high that was. I opened my voice, my mouth to sing on that first chorus there, and my voice was like, nope, nope. Thanks for bearing with us there. This next one's appropriate. This one's called I've Endured here. Well, you guys know this one. It's a great song from Ola Bell Reed, and we'll try it out for you.
I thought you were supposed to have that high lonesome in there.
I know. Yeah. No. Bill Monroe is not coming through that fucking time.
On Sunday, learn the golden rule. I've endured, I've endured. How long must one endure? See many more. I've lived, loved, and sorrowed, been through success's door. I've endured, I've endured. How long must one endure? Born in the mountains many years ago, I've climbed these hills and valleys through all the rain and snow. I've seen the lightning crash and heard the thunder roll. I've endured. I've endured. How long must one endure? I've endured. I've endured. How long must one endure?
Hang tight. We're gonna do scene change here. Well, there's an old man who lives on the countryside of County Armagh near Tabitha's home in Northern Ireland, and we wrote this song for him. I don't think he knows that we wrote this song for him, and he probably should never know that we wrote this song for him, but but he's a lovely old man who farms. He still, you know, rides his tractor and has this little mangy dog that follows him around everywhere off-leash in the green countryside of Northern Ireland. There's a story about them that I just love. He and his brother live in the same house, and you know, they keep the fires going pretty much all year because it's pretty cold over in Northern Ireland. And instead of chopping up the wood to go into the wood stove to heat the whole house, they just stick the trunk of the tree into the fireplace and push it further into the fire as it burns. Isn't that amazing? I love that.
You should probably never know that we told you that either. I mean, like, yeah. I know, he really is. He's a gem of a person. And, you know, he rides his bicycle. He's about, I guess, in his late 80s, and he still rides his bicycle in the countryside, which, again, is just unheard of. First of all, bicycles don't really work in the country of Northern Ireland. David and I figured that out the hard way. We tried to go cycling, thinking, oh, yeah, we're going to go cycling. It was absolutely horrible. If there wasn't a combine harvester coming up behind you, it was some savage dog or something. Don't ride a bicycle in Northern Ireland. Just saying. But yes, this is a song that we wrote for him, and it's also on the EP, and it's called Song for Riddle. This one got off the boat as well. Chased a car or two, but he never runs away. His quiet company is often all I need. I don't move too fast when there's chance of snow, but Sunday morning comes, I'll cycle down the road, down to the meeting house, where they're singing live. I'm unraveling. Hear the birds in the glen. They're all beckoning. They're all beckoning for spring again. There's a stranger in my mirror. So many winters I could see his real figure. He's looking back at me, but he can hardly see. All my dearest friends have come and gone now, and I can feel the bitter wind come from me now. But there's no sad farewell. The old will pass away. Final spring will stay. The old will pass away. The final spring will stay and never end. Oh, bitter winds are chasing me, but I've been set free. But I've been set free. Hear the birds in the glen. They're all beckoning. They're all beckoning for the spring. How did I get into bluegrass? I'm asking myself the question here and also explaining it to you, but I'm sure you're thinking, how on earth, why is she playing bluegrass if she's from Northern Ireland? Well, there really aren't too many players in Northern Ireland, and the Republic of Ireland, there's a bit more, but in Northern Ireland specifically, there's not a whole lot of players, but the ones that there are, they're great, and there's a couple of really cool venues, but there's just really one bluegrass festival, and it's called the Ulster American Folk Park Old Time Appalachian and Bluegrass Festival. I know, yeah, I just call it Bluegrass Festival, and my favorite Bluegrass Festival, but it's set in a cultural heritage park, so they have, it's actually a really cool place. If you ever go to Northern Ireland, you should go check it out, but it has, part of it is in Ulster, and they have a lot of thatched cottages and little straw, you know, roofs and all that kind of stuff, pebble dash, what you think of when you think of Ireland, I'm sure. And then on the other side, they have the New World, which is here, so the US, and it's really cool. They have a ship in the middle that connects both of the things. It sounds pretend. I promise you it's not pretend. There is a ship in the place. And so they have a bluegrass festival there every year, and unfortunately it hasn't happened this past year and last year as well, but it's just so cool, and I've been going since I was about 2. I didn't really have a choice at that stage. My folks brought us, me and my brothers, up listening to bluegrass and old time and just a lot of different things, and we thought it was normal for people to like that kind of music there, but we realized it wasn't, and we had to come over here to feel normal and things. And then so that happened, and I think I was probably about 12 when I really started getting into it, and I started picking up the banjo, and I came across a songwriter who was at the park called Martha Scanlon, and she's just an awesome songwriter, one of my favorites, and she played in an old-time band called the Real Time Travelers, and I'm a big fan, and this is one of the songs that she played, and I've been singing this since I was about 12. And I'm not 12 anymore. I don't think. I don't know what age I am anymore. But yeah, this is called Little Bird of Heaven. It's the thing, when you're sharing instruments with each other, you know, I always leave my tuner on the other instrument, and they're both my instruments, but just saying.
It's my tuner, I'm just saying.
It's my tune. Anyway, okay.
Right there on the side of the can, it's all a bird of heaven right in your hand. So I looked up and I looked back and walked 100 miles on the railroad track. All I can tell from where I stand, little bird of heaven right in your hand. And the fallen leaves and the starling lights on the broken trees. Found we all need a place to land. Little bird of heaven, right there in your hand. So toss it up or pass it around. Pain, no matter what you're carrying around. Dark, you put close, hold it while you can. Little bird of heaven, right there in your hand. Tell me it's a fragile thing and it's hard to fly on broken wings. Finally all need a place to land. It's a little bird of heaven right in your hand. So toss it up or pass it around. Pay no matter what you're carrying around. Dark, keep it close, hold it while you can. Little bird of heaven right in your hand. Can't miles or more, working right there on the side of the can. It's a little brave, but right here in your hand. So toss it upward, pass it around, pay no matter what you can, hang around, dark, keep it close, hold it while you can, little pretty heaven right here in your hand.
You know, we, as David said at the start, this is really our first, I guess, gig together. Definitely my first that I've had to remember all the lyrics, or at least try, which I tell you is something, if you haven't done it for like a year and a half, it's really something you have to get used to again, or just get good at improvising and making them up on the spot, which also is really hard to do. We're not going to tell you where we did that tonight. Yeah, this is a song that I convinced David to sing for you guys, and he don't like singing too much, but I decided it's a duo, and you know, I can't do all the singing, and so I said, David, could you do some singing for me, please? And he said, no, but then I said, can you do some singing for me, please? And he said, no, and then I said, right, you're singing, please. That's the way it was. That was that conversation. No, but I do appreciate that. Also, while I'm just talking, you know, nonsense about you, I'll also show you. David has stickers of his head, if anybody wants one at the back. And that's not, I mean, he's not vain that he just got stickers printed of his head. I mean, it's pretty cool, but he has this Patreon site, and I'm going to just speak a little about this and embarrass you again, but he does mandolin instructional videos and a load of other cool things and interviews with people, and yeah, he's got a lot of fancy gear that I don't ever touch and don't want to use in case I'll break it, but yeah, you should go check that out online. It's David Benedict Mandolin if you're interested in learning mandolin or just looking at some cool little animations that he has, including this one, you know. So if you would like a sticker, you can go to the back and get one. And yeah.
That was just a consolation for making me sing.
Plenty for going.
those lines again.
Just make it up.
But the weeds had been steadily growing. Please don't go. Please don't go. Well, are you going away with no words of farewell? Will there be not a trace left behind? Well, I could have loved you better, didn't mean to be unkind. You know that was the last thing on my mind. Another picking tune here, picking and grinning, as they say, right? This is an instrumental tune I wrote after going over to CTAB for the first time. We met at that IBMA conference in Raleigh, and just kind of became acquaintances there. And Tabitha just nonchalantly said, "Oh, you should come visit. You know, you should come over to Northern Ireland sometime." Probably not even thinking that I'd actually do it. And it just so happened we were over there in January of 2017 or 18, I was 18? The date's very important, I'm sorry. We were over there, and just so happened that a great bluegrass artist by the name of Greg Blake was there touring around, and had a great band of, Mark Schatz was playing bass, and John Reichman playing mandolin, and a bunch of folks that we love in the bluegrass scene, and it was so fun, like, getting to connect with them there at this place called the Red Room, and it's a venue in Cookstown, Northern Ireland, and they're known for bluegrass. And I just thought a place like that deserved a bluegrass fiddle tune named after it. So that's a long story to say. This one's called the Red Room. We'll try it out for you.
Thank you.
thanks so much. We might do one more, and if there's a certain fiddle player in the audience, we might ask him to come up for a couple tunes here at the end. We haven't really even done, we've done a lot of bluegrass, but we love all the music from Tabitha's homeland as well. So, is anyone named Patty out there? Anyone? I just realized that it's spelled with two D's instead of two T's. At least that's what Tabitha says. Is that right? I think.
Don't trust me.
Yeah. Well, if there are any Patties out there, we'll send this one out to you. This one's one we picked up from Cara Dillon, a great Irish singer songwriter over there, and this one's pretty fun. It's called P Stands for Patty.
Well, yo, for Johnny's the fairest one. Oh, Johnny's the fairest one, they say. Johnny is the fairest one. I don't care what anybody says, for Johnny's the fairest one. Well, Pete stands for Patty, I suppose. J for my love, John. Double he stands for the false. Well, yo, for Johnny's the fairest one. Well, Johnny's the fairest one, they say. Johnny is the fairest one. I don't care what anybody says, for Johnny's the fairest one. Me love, beside me on the green. It's on three quarters of a year more. Since together we have been. Since together we have been, my love. Together we have been. It's on three quarters of a year more. Since together we have been. I'll not come sit beside you, love, nor any other time. For I know you'll have another than last, and your heart's no longer mine. Well, your heart's no longer mine, my love. Your heart's no longer mine. For I know you'll have another than last, and your heart's no longer mine. She said, girl of the best. Back I'll bring what I find there to the girl of the best. Well, P stands for Patty, I suppose. J for my love, John. W stands for the false, well, yo. Johnny's the fairest one. Well, Johnny's the fairest one, they say. Johnny's the fairest one. I don't care what anybody says, for Johnny's the fairest one.
Our good friend Brian McDowell join us here on stage for a couple tunes on the fiddle. You guys know Brian, he's an incredible multi-instrumentalist. Doesn't always play fiddle, plays mandolin, guitar, plays everything else, and has won like the national flat picking contest on a bunch of instruments. So we're really lucky to have him here. Please make welcome Brian on the fiddle. Yeah, we'll play a nice fiddle tune for you guys. This one's called Goodbye, Liza Jane.
I just got to say really quick how great y'all are and how much I'm enjoying this show. I hope everyone else here is as much as I am.
Thank you.
Brian McDowell. So, yeah, if it's all right, we might do one more. Is that right? Okay. Yeah. We convinced Brian to do this one with us as well. This was a classic bluegrass tune called Sleep With One Eye Open. We'll send you off with this one here. Thank you guys so much for spending your evening with us, spending your 4th of July weekend with us. And huge thanks to the Isis Music Hall for hosting us, for all the staff here, and all that they do for live music in there. It's amazing. So we hope to be back soon. Come say hello after the show, and thanks so much.
Today, little game you play, while I've been sleeping all my life away. You've been stripping, so they say, between midnight and day. I'm gonna sleep when I open from now on. From now on.
From now on.
All night long.
All night long.
Ain't gonna have a chance to treat your mama wrong. You've been stripping, so they say, between midnight. You were being wise, hanging around with other girls, and leaving me to spend my time alone. Honey, I've got news for you. Your little game's through. And from now on, baby, better tell a lie. From now on.
From now on.
All night long.
All night long.
Ain't gonna have a chance to treat your mama wrong. You've been stripping, So they say, between midnight and day, I'm gonna sleep.